Hello guys, welcome back. In this video session, we'll be discussing about the class 7th perimeter and area, important chapter, class 11th, sorry, chapter 11th, class 7th. Okay, so in this video session, we'll be discussing exercise 11.3 topics, not the questions. Okay, so topic is basically, it is all based on area of, I can say, area of circle as well as perimeter of circle, okay, and perimeter of circle. On these two topics, it's basically based on 11.3 is based on only these two things, that is perimeter of circle and area of circle. Now basically in the questions it will be given circumference also. Now what do you mean by circumference? Circumference is basically perimeter only, okay. So try to understand, circumference is basically perimeter. So for the circle, it's circumference, that's it. Now what will be the area of circle? Now area of circle, I can draw a circle, okay, from the center. This will be the radius, right? I can denote by smaller, always denote by what? Smaller. Okay, you can denote it by capital R also. Basically it is denoted by smaller. Now what will be, if I extend this, what will be the both this? This is also R, right? R, R, same line, okay? In the same line, I am extending this line towards the end of the circle. Now R, R, R plus R will give me what? R plus R will give me what? 2R, right? R plus R is 2R. So this is basically 2R means diameter. You can observe in the diagram also. See, this is basically what R plus R, these two combining towards together will form a diameter D, small d, denoted by what? Small d. So this is basically diameter. So I can write one more thing, that is diameter is nothing but 2R, right? 2 times radius, and radius is nothing but half of diameter. Try to analyze these two formulas. Okay, this is a relationship between diameter and radius. So diameter is nothing but 2 times radius, and radius is half of diameter. Okay, suppose if I take one value, suppose I'll take in place of R 3 centimeter. Okay, now in place of R I have taken 3 centimeter. If you want to find the diameter, what will you do? You have to just keep in this diameter equal to 2 times R. What is R here? 3. So diameter equal to 2 times R, that will give me 6 centimeter. So diameter of this will be 6 centimeter, right? That's it. Now if suppose if you want to find, suppose if diameter is given, suppose in place of this line is there, diameter is there, diameter value is 12 centimeters, suppose. Now how to find the radius? Radius is equal to half of diameter. So radius is equal to what? Half of diameter. Radius, diameter is given as 12. 12 by 2 is nothing but 6 centimeters. So I got the radius as 6 centimeters. So that's the basic concept behind the, or we can say the relationship between diameter and the radius. You have to analyze first this. Now moving on to the area of the diameter. Okay, now area of the diameter is given, area of the circle, sorry, area of circle is nothing but pi r square. This is the area of circle. Pi is nothing but the constant value, which is given as 3.14, or I can say 22/7. This is a constant value, will not change. Okay, constant value means that value is already given. So pi value, you have to remember always, that is 3.14, or we can use 22/7. In some questions it may be mentioned that we have to use pi as 3.14, or we have to use pi as 22/7. So there we have to use that value only. Try to understand. Now pi r square, pi r square, R square basically means pi R square is there. This basically means pi we are R we are multiplying two times R into R. R square means R into R. Okay, so radius we have to multiply twice. So R square does not mean that we are multiplying with 2. This is the wrong assumption or wrong thing. We are multiplying R twice. That means we are multiplying R into R. Okay, try to analyze this. We are not multiplying 2 with R. That's the basic concept. Now, R square means R into R. Okay, now we'll take up one example to understand this. Suppose area of circle we have to find, and the radius is given as, or we can say diameter is given as 12 centimeter. Okay, we have to find the area. How to find the area? Area formula is pi r square. So what is pi? 3.14 we can take, or we can take 22/7. So 22/7 will be, I think, more simple, or we can say for the calculation it is better to take 22/7 instead of 3.14, because it is a decimal value, you have to multiply and all. If it is mentioned in the question, you have to take 3.14 only. Okay, so I'll take here 22/7. What is R here? R, it is not given directly thing. Okay, try to understand. We cannot write 12 into 12. Why? Because this is given as diameter, so we cannot write 12 into 12. So you have to convert diameter into radius. So diameter is what? 2r, right? Radius is nothing but half of diameter. Okay, so radius is half of diameter. So from this I can write radius as what? Half of diameter is 6 centimeter. So radius will be 6. So I have to multiply 6 2 times. Okay, r square means r into r, that is 6 into 6. So that will give me 36, so 22 into 36/7. Multiply this numerator by this, it will give you answer. So unit will be centimeter square. Find out this answer. Okay, now, so first thing you have to remember, when it is not given as radius, you have to convert it to radius first. That's the first important thing. Okay, then only we can put it, or we can substitute the R value here. Now moving on to the perimeter of the circle, or it is also called as circumference of the circle. So in the questions will be given circumference. So don't get confused, it is not the area, it is the perimeter. Okay, so what is the formula for circumference of a circle? It is nothing but 2 pi r of a circumference of the circle means boundary of the circle. Okay, now suppose, okay, r is nothing but radius, right? Pi we know value, 2 we know, that's it. Okay, now we'll take one question, try to analyze that. Suppose it is given r as 3 centimeter. Okay, so find the area of this. How to find the area? Simple, we are not the area, we have to find the perimeter. So 2 into what is pi value? 22/7, or we can take 3.14 into what is r again? 3 centimeter. Okay, 2 into 3, 6, 6 into 22, so 22 into 6/7. Multiply and get the answer. This will be in centimeter. That's it. Okay, so this is the basic concept. Here, if it is given as diameter, you have to convert into radius, because in the formula it is given as radius. Okay, don't get confused. When diameter is given, first thing you have to do is that convert it to radius. Then only we can substitute here. If suppose you want to find the area, or the, we can say, perimeter of a semicircle. What do you understand by the word semicircle? Semicircle basically means, so I'll just write it here. See, half of the circle. So circle is nothing but like this, right? Half of the circle. Half of the circle is nothing but semicircle. So this will be semicircle. Okay. So perimeter of semicircle. What is the perimeter of the semicircle? So perimeter of semicircle is nothing but C. So semicircle is nothing but a half of a circle. So perimeter of a semicircle will be C. Perimeter of full circle is what? 2 pi r. Half of that will be pi r, right? So divide by 2, basic thing. So pi r. So perimeter of a semicircle will be pi r. Now suppose you are asking that we have to find the semicircle whole this thing. So basic thing here is that you have to add this diameter also. See, you have to try to understand. Semicircle circumference or the perimeter will be pi r plus d. Why d? See, observe here. This is nothing but the circumference. See, boundary means this whole thing is the boundary. When I cut it into this part, so from here to here will be the circumference. This is not included in this formula. That you would understand. So you have to add d in order to get the circumference of a whole figure. That is the figure. Okay. So circumference of a half circle will be, semicircle will be pi r plus d. Okay. That's it. And what about the area? Area will be nothing but what? Pi r square will be the area of a full circle. Half circle will be pi r square by 2. No change in this. We have no need to add because see here, area will be the whole thing. Half of this will be the half of that area. That is pi r square by 2. That's it.